Hey guys, welcome again to another tutorial on the 8086 assembly. In this video, we'll finally learn how to draw a pixel on the screen using the assembly language. On the next videos, the same process will be used to draw the ball and the pedals, so this video will be really awesome. So, first, we'll learn about the interruption 10H and its supported functions. We'll use this interruption to set a video mode and to draw the pixel. We will look at the different graphic or video modes available to us and what differentiates every one of them. Then, after learning all this information and where we can search for it, we will draw our awesome pixel on the screen. Let's go! So, let's start by going through what we made in the previous lesson. Our little assembly code to print an A character. Let's go to Dodgebox. Remember that we need to mount a C drive and then pass the folder of our Pong folder users, the name of the user, desktop, and then Pong. If we type there, you can see that we are not already in the Pong folder. We first need to go to the C drive. So C, and then if we go and type there, we can see that we are in the Pong folder. If we run Pong, we see an A printed on the screen. Not very fun, I guess. Now, we can make this quicker by telling Dodgebox our initial configurations. For this, we need to edit the configuration file of Dodgebox. So go, search for Dodgebox, and then click on Dodgebox options. Here we can see the file containing all the Dodgebox configurations. To override the initial configurations, you go all the way down, and in the auto executable section, we write all the lines that we want to Dodgebox to run at startup. So let's put our initial configuration here, mount C, and the folder of our program, name of the user, desktop, Pong, and then only C. It's done, let's save. And now, if we go to Dodgebox, all the initial configurations are already made for us. If we go there, you can see that we are in the Pong folder. Let me try to clean our Dodgebox screen with CLS, of course. Now, let's start with our little drawing thing. Let's get rid of this awesome code on the right. So, to write the pixel on the screen, we need a beautiful thing called an interruption. In this case, the 10H interruption. So, this link for Wikipedia. This interruption will allow us to play with the video services, provides video services, and for the purposes of this lesson, setting the video mode. And here we go, writing pixels in graphics mode. In this table below is listed the function, set video mode, the function code that will trigger the function, and the parameters. In this case, we put in AL the index of the video mode we want. So, knowing this, let's start writing our code. First, we need to set the video mode. To do this, we need to know which video mode to choose and what types we can use. So, let's ask Dr. Google in 10H video modes. I have already seen this link, it's awesome, it's linked in the description of this video too. Let's select our function, set video mode. And here we can see an entire list of the video modes available and the respective number to the parameter passed into the AL register. You have test modes, graphic modes, all sorts of things. This mode, I think, is the default 00 text mode. Here in this lesson we go with this. 320 by 200, 256 colors, and the we pass to the AL13. So let's start by calling this this function. So let's get rid of this. Move to the AH register 00H, and then move to the AL video mode that we want. The video mode that we want is the 13, the 13.1 for this video mode. 13. So let's go again to the code. 13H. And now we're calling the function. We're setting the video mode to the 13H. Now we need to call the interruption to execute all these actions. So we need to call the interruption 10H. To do this, we simply type int for interruption, and then we pass the name of the interruption, 10H. Now if you go to DodgeBox and run our program, we first need to do the MASM thing, pong.asm, the semicolon to skip, the linkage, link pong, semicolon escape, and then pong. We can see that strange things happen. If we go press enter and type everything, appear as an art. So what is happening? Let's exit and open a new instance of DodgeBox. And now, how to replace the strange text. Now, we already switched from the previous text mode into the graphic mode. But for now, we're not drawing anything. So let's start by setting our black background. Let's go down here. You can see here this set background function with this function codes. So let's start our background programming by doing this. First, let's write some meaningful comments in our code that we have already made. All comments in assembly start with a semicolon. Set video. Set video mode. Here, it's very important that you comment your code so others and you could understand in plain English what you're writing. So choose the video mode and then execute the configuration. So now let's start by writing the function codes for the background configuration. Move. Oh, oops. Need to write the function code, so move to the AH register 0BH to the PH register 00H. So here is setting the configuration. Set the configuration to the background color, to the background color. Now we need to pass to the BL register the background color we want. Background color, as you can see here. So you can see the colors available to us here in this link. Open link in the tab. And this list is the colors available and the respective codes in decimal, hexadecimal, and binary. We want a black color for the background, so the code is 00 here, as you can see. 00H in hexadecimal, so we move to the BL register 00H. Here we're choosing as the background, oops, shows black as background. And now we execute with the calling again of the int 10h interruption. Int 10h. And we can see now, so we need to do the MASM thing, masm/a/pong.asm. Linkage, link pong. And we can see that nothing changes, because the background was already black. So, it's time to draw our little pixel on the screen. Let's open Dodgebox again. Let's write a comment here too, on this interruption. So, we are again executing the configuration. Now, let's search for some type of function to draw the pixel. Let's go again to this list. You can see here, this function writes a pixel to the screen. Given this function codes, AH, we pass to the AL register a color, the page number to BH, the position in X to CX, and the vertical position into the DX register. Let's start by moving to the AH register 0CH, the function code of the function, 0CH. So set the configuration to writing a pixel. Move to the EAL, the white color. That is, as you can see in this list, F, 15 in decimal, F in hexadecimal. So we move to the AL 0FH. Choose, set the, choose is better. So choose as, choose white as color for the pixel, of course. We set the page number BH to be 0, because we only have this page. So set the page number. And now we move to the CX, the X position. So move CX. You could try any number. I'll go with 10 for X. So 0AH. In hexadecimal. So set the column, the X position. And then for the vertical position on the X, I will go again with 0AH. So set the line, the Y position. We execute all this by calling again the TNH interruption. So execute the configuration. So it's all done here. So let's run our Pong game. MASM/A/Pong.asm. Semicolon to skip. The linkage, link Pong. And now running, you can see an awesome little pixel in the screen. I challenge you now to play with the colors and X and Y position. In the next video, we'll start creating our ball.